Hello, everyone, and welcome to Action RPG. I'm your host, Aaron, and it's Saturday, so you know what that means. It's time for our weekly news roundup for week 47. Yes, we are already nearing the end of this year, and as the holiday approaches, all these gaming companies and gaming studios are dropping lots of information, games, updates, and a lot came out this week. So make sure you stick around till the end of the video. All right. Let's jump right into this. Starting off with my current favorite ARPG, and that of course is Last Epoch. Now, yesterday, the devs over at 11th Hour Games dropped a huge gem on us of information. Coming December 4th, 2020, which is less than 2 weeks away, we are going to be getting the Rogue class. That's right. Coming from the shadows, a swift blade, the Rogue accepts her next hit coming December 4th. Let me play this quick little teaser video for you now. Enjoy. The 2020 Game Awards are right around the corner, December 10th, and all the nominees have now been officially announced. Now, I'm not going to go through all the different categories, but what I will do is link this article in the description below if you want to check it out for yourself. But let's quickly take a look at the Game of the Year nominations. All right. Animal Crossing, of course. Doom Eternal. Final Fantasy VII Remake. Ghost of Tsushima. 80s and Last of Us Part 2. I cannot believe the Last of Us Part 2 has made this list. That being said, if I had to pick a game from this list that I think deserves Game of the Year, I am going with Ghost of Tsushima. That is my pick for Game of the Year, and it was a game that nobody knew was going to do as well as it did, so it's kind of got that underdog vibe to it. And the game was amazing. So that is my selection. The survival MMO Last Oasis dropped on us a new Steam post, which announced that this game is officially coming to Xbox One, S, and X. So you can now play Last Oasis with your Xbox friends. This information was also accompanied with a little 30 second teaser video, which I will play for you in 4K in a few seconds. I just wanted to add a little bit of information. If you ever planned on playing Last Oasis, it is a weird kind of post-apocalyptic survival MMO where everybody is on these weird, like, walking vehicles and they attack each other. Anyways, this game is scheduled for a full wipe Sunday the 22nd, tomorrow. Okay, so you can get in the same time as everybody else because the game is going to have a completely full wipe. Okay, let me play for you this teaser trailer with the game coming to Xbox, and you kind of get an idea of what these little land ships look like. Enjoy. This week, NCSoft had its quarter three call where we found out lots of new information about my most highly anticipated game, Project TL. Now, I already made a video this week breaking down everything that we learned around Project TL, and I will link that video at the end of this video if you want to see that. But let me give you the Cliff Notes version. NCSoft conducted large-scale internal testing of Project TL in August and September, for the purpose of checking overall game feel and functionality. Siege Warfare mode was popular and found to be very competitive, and the overall results of the test were very encouraging. Now, it also says here, three games launching in 2021, and right here it says Project TL. But that's not all. It also says this game is coming to multiple platforms. So Project TL, the South Korean MMORPG, will be available on PC and next-gen consoles. But that's not it. It also says it's for overseas audiences. Now, a lot of time we get excited about these South Korean MMOs. Lost Ark, we want to play, and they literally never come to the West. This game, at least what NCSoft is telling us right now, it is it will be have a global launch, which means when this game comes 1.0, we should be able to play it in the West. Which makes me very, very, very excited. Okay, one other little thing about NCSoft. They're no longer going to be calling themselves NCSoft, and I know this is kind of silly, but it's important to know so that when you change, you know what NC is. September 2021, NCSoft will be coming just NC. They don't want to be known as Soft. Really silly. Anyways, this is kind of a banner that they put out showing that they're just going to be NC. World of Warcraft Shadowlands is now right around the corner. This expansion officially drops Monday, November 23rd. Literally 2 days away. Now, one thing that Blizzard does very well is their cinematics. The company normally drives me crazy, but the cinematics and the time they put into creating them for their games are normally world class. And with Shadowlands, we got a new launch cinematic. Look at this guy right here. Now, earlier in the week, I made a 4K game trailer for this launch cinematic. Took the trailer, completely re-rendered it in 4K, and then uploaded it. Now, I'm going to link that video at the end of this video if you want to check out that trailer. I'm going to play a tidbit for you now so you kind of get an idea of what they were going for. Enjoy. Love it or hate it, Assassin's Creed Valhalla has been a huge success for Ubisoft. Check this out. Assassin's Creed Valhalla has sold more units in its first week than any other Assassin's Creed game before. But that's not it. Not only is this the largest Assassin's Creed game launch ever, it's also the top-selling Ubisoft PC launch ever. The best PC launch game that they have ever had. On top of that, this is the first time in 13 years that a game has outranked a Call of Duty launch in sales. Assassin's Creed Valhalla beat out Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Now, they have not dropped on us what the official number is, how much units, or what that revenue looks like, but we do know that before Assassin's Creed Valhalla, the top dog was Assassin's Creed 3, and that game sold 3.5 million units. So all I know is that this game sold more than 3.5 million units during its launch week. Ubisoft is cleaning up. They love in those microtransactions. On top of that, let's check out Metacritic to see how the game is holding up. So right now, I'm going to look at PC only, but it's scoring an 85, so a solid B from 22 critics, but the user rating has slipped a little bit. This was sitting in the low 80s for a while. It has now dipped to 7.6, so it's still green and it's still a C. So, you know, it's a playable, fun game. We're not talking about in the 90s and we're not talking about in the 60s. Users think the game is average. That doesn't change the fact that it is killing sales numbers right now. Potentially one of the most hyped games of all time, Cyberpunk 2077 is right around the corner. This game is officially coming December 10th, and because of that, we are getting tons of information drops on us on this game. Now we know the new system requirements if you want to play this game with ray tracing turned on. Check this out. If you want to play at 1080p, The graphics card you need is an RTX 2060. If you want to play at 1440p, the requirements are an RTX 3070. If you want to play at Ultra 2160, the requirements are an RTX 3080. Now, I already made a video this week breaking down this even further. And again, I will link that at the end of this video if you want to check it out. But think about that for a second. This game drops December 10th. Those 3000 series video cards came out only a couple of months ago, and they are literally sold out everywhere. When was the last time you saw the system requirements for the game being the mid to high-end GPU that just came out a few months previously? That, by the way, you can't even purchase. Those are some big requirements. Now, they did show this video. It's a behind-the-scenes video. And again, this will be in the video I link at the end of this video, showing what ray tracing looks like in this game. And it looks amazing. I mean, it really looks good. Like, next-gen visuals good. So, if you're one of the lucky ones that were able to get a hold of the 3000 series GPUs, you are lucky and you should grab this game. Okay, little funny tidbit of information. Now, we already know that the game will be 70 gigs, okay, at minimum to download. But if you get it on PS4, it comes in two discs. It has been a long time since I have seen console game release that gives you two discs for the game. Cyberpunk 2077. Lastly, Keanu Reeves is canon for Cyberpunk 2077. His character is not just going to be a cameo, not going to be some weird skin, not going to be someone you bump into in town or just be a side mission. His character will be a big part of the story, canon for Cyberpunk 2077, which is awesome. If you follow my weekly news roundups, I try to close with a statistic. Now, you probably are thinking, why did I not use Assassin's Creed Valhalla? Yes, those stats are very impressive, but I decided to hold that for A3 Still Alive. Last or not least, this new mobile RPG has hit 1 million downloads already. 1 million people have downloaded this new RPG on a mobile device. And I do have to say, I am one of them. I'm currently running a Templar, and I think I'm like level 50 or 55. But the game is pretty addictive. It is kind of one of those time waste games where you literally never run out of things to do, but it's fun. You can play as a group. It's that guild mentality. I enjoy the game itself. Now, what they are doing for their 1 million downloads is they have the celebration event where they just basically give you a whole bunch of goodies. Let me quickly play for you some gameplay for A3 Still Alive, because I think more people should download the game if you are looking for something to do in the mobile arena. Enjoy. right, everybody, that's going to wrap up week 47. If potentially I missed any big stories, please let me know in the comment section below. If you have not joined the official Action RPG Discord, please do so. We're now over 400 members, great conversations every day. The idea is to create a gaming community that could jump from game to game together so you never start the server alone. Link for that Discord is in the description. Thank you all for watching. Stay home, stay safe. Do not forget to join the official Action RPG Discord. Aaron.